so many images out of social media. It's like trying to find something more, something that's at the core of everything. Ellipsis is a term in continuity editing filmmaking where a portion of the narrative of the film is edited out either because it's too obvious or the viewer can infer the information that's been left out. It's 24 sequential frames of a fantasy film which represent 1 second of time. It's sort of the idea of fragmenting what you can see as like a fleeting moment and sort of breaking that down and kind of what that actually is and how that can be read differently once it's pinned. The, like, the transitional nature of it, or it's sort of between, it's like something being between two states, so it's like between the film and the object. Threshold also refers to the idea of like endurance as well, so like the idea of, say, like pain threshold is the threshold of the distortion and how much pain through the image can take. And what happens in the reading of the frames, the film, when they're translated in this way, and then placed sequentially so that you kind of track the movement of the subject. You're also like put in the position of the film, the filmmaker, or the photographer. She's kind of sort of turning to look at the camera and she realizes she's being filmed and then she sort of looks away. It's kind of interesting to put the viewer in the position of the cameraman, so it's like a forced intimacy. So you're kind of like surrounded by this lady. It's like almost creating multiple versions of this lady, so it kind of takes on the idea of like restating the sort of artificial nature of the image. Using the thing to get across the feeling and looking at something, or that feeling of a figure in transition or a figure in motion. The fleeting presence of the person rather than just on a physical level. At first you're like, oh yeah, it's a woman smiling, and then once you kind of look into the repetition of it, it becomes, it sort of almost becomes uncanny, or it's kind of aware of the construction of it rather than if it was just a single image. It's not quite operating in that way, but I think the repetition of it also reinforces that brutality. I've got like loads and loads of films, and there's like at least 3 minutes on each one, which is like hundreds of frames to look through. In a work like Threshold, you kind of have an awareness of me looking through all the other films for hours and hours, and that kind of like intense, like active looking. With the montage work, I think there's more of a relationship to abstraction. The sort of imperfections of the film as graphic devices that then sort of put alongside the images in quite a literal way, so you get like spotted holes or borders and marks that are on the film. And the idea of the film interrupting the image that it's trying to recall is quite interesting to me. So, like the marks and things are quite arbitrary, like they might, this one the montage one, where there's a hole right across somebody's face. It's like a graphic device to get that brutality. It's kind of sometimes quieter in my work, but kind of comes more to the front, I think, of the reading of it. I think also because they're such a large scale, there's more room for that dynamic between the bush marks and the image. So you could have a mark that's like this big, but then when you stand back, it kind of reads. It's sort of interesting to push that. Sort of trying to push the format of painting, somehow to find something that's a new way of using painting. So you just got the first frame and the last frame, and none of the kind of information between those points. So like montage again is a filmmaking term where it's the idea of combining images together to manipulate the reading of those images. So these paintings are again about that inference of what you read between the two images. What's missing is like a sort of the very sort of dense pebbly images, but you're also aware that you're not getting the full information. The images have come from reality and been extracted from a sequence of events, and the sort of manipulation of the images to open out the reading of them. So it's quite interesting in terms of like ideas of like collective memory and loss and things like that. It sort of opens up quite a sort of sealed image of people on holiday, becomes something quite evocative or can become quite powerful in a different way to just if the image is just sentimental. It's like trying to use images that could potentially be sentimental, but editing them and painting them in a way that brings out what I feel when I look at them, which isn't sentimental, it's something quite a little bit darker or... Yeah, again, that sort of lack of narrative is more interesting to me, or the way they can open up so that they become part of like a collective reading or collective experience rather than specifically about that person. So I think they always have a sort of familiarity, but then there's a kind of alien thing about them too, like, you think, oh yeah, that's something, you know, the montage. In the show, it's montage 5. It's like, you know, like a lady sunbathing, but then you sort of look at the face and it's all sort of distorted and it's not quite like you're not looking at what you think you're looking at. The idea of the levels of reading of an image as well is interesting to me. And sort of using the paint to do a lot of the distortion as well, letting the paint fill in the gaps, but then it sort of opens up the reading. Yeah, Rerun is, again, it's a sort of film reference. So it's like the idea of a film being shown again after its initial run. So it's like the idea of this sequence of images being caught in like perpetual motion almost. So it's like it's rerunning, so you look through the images and then you just kind of, your eye twists around and around, but it's like how the format of the painting can be manipulate the engagement of you with the image. So it's kind of a different relationship to if it was just a single image, you look at it and go, all right, that's that. But if it's there's eight of them, it's kind of, it catches, you get caught in the rhythm of the painting. So it's based on the sequential film frames, but it's sort of more. But with that one, I was interested in getting the feeling of the sort of flicker, so the movement's not quite as extreme as in Threshold. It's not like a sort of a complete movement, it's like maybe like the feeling of the subject coming towards you as the viewer. And how, again, it's like placing the viewer in the position of the cameraman and that kind of feeling of intimacy, but, and sort of what you're risking upon. That kind of uncanny feeling of you being in the wrong place, like you're looking at someone who's not, they don't think they're looking at you. And the other thing is Semblance, which is a sort of singular image of a sort of a film frame which just flashed up really briefly, like for one frame. So I'm sort of trying to collect lots of images. This is one of them, of images that just flash up momentarily that you would kind of miss in the flow of the sequence of images. And again, it's that kind of idea of the accident and how, so that person might flash up momentarily by accident, they might not realise they're being filmed, and that the gap between the intention and what seeps through. I think it's also interesting with that one that it's the only image where the subject's kind of looking directly away from the viewer. In the shadows of the subject kind of joining up, but it's kind of almost like a, reminds me of those like Victorian spirit photographs, so like seances and that kind of occult kind of imagery. I think it would definitely make very different work if it wasn't from where I'm from. There is a definite sort of tone to the sensibility of people who come from somewhere like that. I think it's quite sort of industrial, sort of working class kind of place. You're sort of from somewhere that there's not really much time for daydreaming or idealism. It's more like realism.